The game is afoot. The developer Frogware and publisher Dreamcatcher provides a different approach to the infamous serial killer Jack the Ripper, who terrorized London in 1888 by killing prostitutes. Without forensics and with little to no information made available to the police, the killer was never found, and no one was convicted for the brutal murders. In this game, only the renowned detective, Sherlock Holmes, with the help of his good friend...
Move a muscle or I shoot.
Who? But... what is going on?
Bravo, Watson. I take back everything I ever said about your less than full involvement in our investigations.
Dr. Watson will be able to solve this horrible crime. At the time, the Industrial Revolution was in full swing. The British Empire was at its peak, and as in England, was pretty much the best world power. England's model of wealth radiated throughout the world. However, the Whitechapel district in the east end of London hardly reflected this brilliant reality. Whitechapel was the capital's most horrible neighborhood. With its boundaries lived England's most horrible, including alcoholics, beggars, and prostitutes, as well as a large community of Jewish immigrants fleeing Eastern Europe's ever-growing persecution. In this terrible hole of misery, tens of thousands of people lived crammed within a maze of narrow, sinister, stinky streets, overshadowed by fog. To deal with the poverty, the government created public workhouses in an attempt to manage the masses. It's within this sinister set, faithfully rendered in all its details and similar to a playground, that you'll have to investigate and track Jack the Ripper's bloody trail and solve one of the greatest mysteries of crime. Now, the graphics for the main part of the game are okay. The game was originally a PC title, so this game was completely ported from the PC to the Xbox 360, minus the achievements. Now, the graphics do look pretty good, but I think they could have done a little bit better on the graphics themselves and make it a little bit more high res. But other than that, I think they do look pretty good, and they get the job done. Even though I kind of wish the voice acting would be a little bit better. The voice acting can kind of get stale once in a while, and I would have probably preferred the actors from the Sherlock Holmes movie, but...
We are lost, Holmes.
No, we're not, Watson.
Why?
That's just me. Anyway, the graphics themselves look okay, and the environments that you walk around will look really, really cool. And I thought they did a really good job doing the environments in the game. Now, the interface is very easy to navigate, dividing the reference material into sensible categories so you are able to focus where you wish. The inventory system is very basic and not cluttered at all. I never reached a point where I needed to pick up something and didn't have room in the inventory. There are some puzzles that require combining items, and there may be a requirement to test what must be placed together in the expected order. But none of these proved to be a barrier. The game allows you to move and explore either in first-person or third-person perspectives. I mainly used the first-person mode, which I thought was a fresh new take on the point-and-clicker adventure game genre, and I had no troubles. I think the third-person mode resulted in some camera issues because there are some confined spaces. There are a few instances when it was hard to notice the sweet spot that the game expected you to either pick up items or open doors and windows. Unfortunately, the game suffers from a couple of technical issues. One of the main ones would be freezing. When I first started the game, I usually install the game to a hard drive, since I have a 120GB hard drive. When it's not filled with over 60 gigs of demos, I usually install some of my games to the hard drive, and usually when I get review copies, that's the first thing I do, just in case it gets scratched up. I was actually fairly surprised that when I installed it to my hard drive, started a new game, and watched the initial Watson/Holmes scene, and then while it was loading the next thing to start playing, it froze. Well, I then uninstalled it and just played off the disc, and it worked fine, aside from the noise of the lawnmower-ish fan. It played directly from the disc fine. After saving, after running off the disc, and then reinstalling and resuming from a saved, since I saved right before leaving Holmes' apartment for the first time, I haven't really run into the problem since. Just make sure to run it off the disc. Those looking for replay value will be disappointed. There is only one mode. I think the game could have had maybe a different outcome and changed some things up if you played it again. Sherlock Holmes vs. Jack the Ripper has 40 achievements, which equal to 1,000 gamer score points. Some of the achievements are very simple, but some can be easily missed the first time through. So there is a little bit of replay value here. And for those looking for easy achievements, you also get a really good story out of this. Now, the game lasts on average 10 to 12 hours. If you're a big mystery fan, then I can see some people playing the story again since it's so well written. Now, the story is easy to follow. Where to go is easy to figure out. What to do is normal in difficulty, but how to solve some of the puzzles, well, they're mostly hard. The game requires you to think, and sometimes to be a very good observer of the surroundings. It's a great adventure game, and if you like to investigate, then you'll lose track of time playing this game. The game compels you to continue, and each scene is worthwhile to watch and listen to rather than skipping through. Besides the freezing problems and some of the graphics messing up, the graphics look pretty nice. Though they could have been a little bit better instead of being from a straight port. I could recommend this game to anyone interested in either Sherlock Holmes, point-and-click adventure games, or mystery games. The game is currently $30, and I think that's a reasonable price for the amount of content you're getting. And out of 10, I would give it an 8 out of 10, and I definitely think you should buy it now. And if any people from Frogware or Dreamcatcher are listening, well, guys, maybe you could port some of the other games over, but try to make it just a little bit, have a little bit more replay value next time. But anyway, it's really cool, it's a good game. If you're looking for a good mystery game, this would definitely be it. And if you're on the fence about this, then give it a rent, at least. And if you like it, then go for a buy. Thanks for watching. If you have any questions, concerns, or any review requests, please email us at weliketoreview@gmail.com, leave a comment on the video, please leave a comment on our channel, or private message us. And, yeah, so if you like this review, then please subscribe. You can if you want to, and you'll be notified when our next review is up.
This story is frightful, Holmes.
Indeed, Watson. Lies, infidelity, venereal disease, murder, mutilation, and finally cannibalism. A complete anthology of what humans at their most vile are capable.
Let's go at once to Whitechapel and put this madman where he can do no more harm, Holmes.
Let's, Watson.